You begin your journey with certain tools. In the final analysis, you have to leave everything. Sufi says, Tarke Tark, Tarke Ukba, Tarke Mola. In the beginning, logic is very important. Why are you entering into this? Because you are aspiring for Ukba, the other world. And Master is the one who helps you. Along the journey, first you have to abandon logic, then you have to abandon the desire for Ukba, and then you have to abandon the Mola, Master. Nanak's entire message of Japji has been based on remembrance, Surati. Surati, or the remembrance or awareness of that which is. This is a tool. You begin with this. Now he is almost nearing the end of his message. Nanak says even Surati or awareness or remembrance is meaningless. This is something strange and conflicting, but this is how the spiritual journey is. This is significant. All along the way he emphasized Surati, remembrance, awareness, and now he is saying something different, but it is so. In the final analysis, you have to leave everything. And in the final analysis, even Surati or awareness becomes an obstacle. And this is the last obstacle, just as Master is the last obstacle. It was your effort to maintain awareness. Therefore, awareness becomes an instrument in the hands of ego. Nanak did not ask you to leave awareness earlier. But in the final analysis, he is asking you to even discard the remembrance, awareness, Surati. Try to understand this. You want to climb the roof. For this, you can use a ladder or steps or another device. Your objective of using this device is to reach the roof, not the device is important. You use escalator, you use elevator to reach the roof. There are various ways and means to reach to the higher floor. You can use ordinary steps, you can use escalator, you can use elevator. These are the various devices available at different places. Your objective is not the use of device, but to reach to the top. Therefore, when you are reaching the last step of the ladder, would you go on holding on to the ladder? In that case, you will not reach the roof. Another example can be your taking medicines. You take medicines to get better. And when you reach the last dose, do you still hold on to the medicine or hold on to the prescription and empty bottles? This we understand. And when you get better, you discard all the empty bottles. Maybe for some time you keep the x-rays and you keep the prescriptions, then one day you discard these two. Nanak wants to take away everything from your hands. This is the way he goes on removing any possibility for ego to make any claim. It may happen that the person may say that I have so many tools to do the carving of the fruits and vegetables. But once you take out your set of tools, carving tools to do the work, and once you have finished, you put aside the tools. Everyone sees the result, not the tools. Those who are desirous of knowing how did you do that, for them these tools may be relevant. But for others who only want to enjoy the fruits, these tools are meaningless. This is the way Nanak goes on removing any possibility of ego to make any claim. You may claim that you have so many types of ladders, such a wide repertoire of tools, that can help in carving, but what that has to do with someone who knows nothing? This can strengthen your ego. Nanak says you cannot attain many. You cannot attain many. Tried speaking as the device to attain, but they all failed. Seeing these, other use silence as the device, they too failed. Thus Nanak goes on all the devices one by one. Why is he taking away these things one after the other? All these things will certainly strengthen your ego. The answer to each question, who is speaking, who is observing silence, who is taking care of this awareness, who is singing, who is coming to do this, all these things. In fact, it is you who is doing all these things. None of these things can change your intrinsic qualities. If by nature you are the sinner, then speaking cannot make you virtuous. You think by observing silence you will attain. By observing silence nothing will happen as long as I am remains. When you meditate, you say you are meditating. This is the undercurrent of ego. I have heard once Mullah Nasruddin became a state minister. He always knew that he was a great orator and no one can match his oratory. But he gave long speeches. Police had to safeguard all the meetings. Police was there to prevent people from going out. Still, people were not interested in his speeches. People felt bored and some even yawned and slept. Seeing this, he asked his secretary to prepare short speeches, as long speeches are causing problems for his reputation. So the secretary wrote short speech. After the speech was over, Mullah found that people were still bored. So he got angry with his secretary because in spite of his instructions to prepare short speeches, he had prepared a long one. At this, the secretary humbly pleaded his innocence. He said that he has prepared a short speech, but the problem arose because instead of reading one copy, you read all the three copies. He prepared us several versions of the short speeches. Intelligence cannot be borrowed. You can get your speech written. The intrinsic quality cannot be borrowed. If you are devil-like, then even in your silence you will remain a devil. What can you give? And what in reality you have? You are seeking money from God and then you go on giving money. You are building temples, one who is seeking and one who is giving, their eyes are focused on money. It may be possible the seeker may be humble, but how can the one who is giving remain humble? He will claim himself to be the giver. There is only one giver, Nanak says. What do you have that you want to give? Pebbles? Gold, silver, silver coins and currency notes. All these are assumptions and the concepts of man. Nanak says neither seeking nor giving is meaningful. So too, neither life nor death is meaningful. These are two sides of the same coin. Therefore, these remain dualistic. An all ultimate state is going beyond duality. Life has not given you the taste of the ultimate. Then you think maybe death may give that experience. You will find them in around in ashrams. No one is courageous to die instantaneously. They prefer a slow death. As soon as you leave the world of activity, 90% of life is finished automatically. Now you are in the spiritual centers. Maybe you may again abandon one meal. This is like death. Through life, you could not attain. Then how would you attain in death? You move from one place to another. Nothing has changed in your understanding. Nanak says, allow peace to echo in your heart. Some accumulate money and then count. Others make resolutions. Some meditate. Others engage in austerities. However, none of these are meaningful. And the most significant thing that Nanak says is that not even the memory or knowledge or thought is meaningful. Nanak goes even one step forward. He says even your constant remembrance that he once emphasized so much is meaningful. Many have considered thoughts to be meaningless. Thoughts is like a wave on the surface. Many have found knowledge to be meaningless. All that you have accumulated from the scriptures or from others cannot be meaningful. This is all borrowed. Now he hits the last, not even remembrance is meaningful. This is the paradox. There are two things. First is the remembrance. The second stage is the experience that what will happen when remembrance settles in you. You are the one who remembers. All remembrance and calls will have his quality. How can this be meaningful? You are now approaching the second when everything slips from your head. Never be in a haste for this stage. Even if a slightest effort remained, then it will be meaningless. This is the final moment. When nothing else remains to do, then it slips out of your hand. If you are leaving because of its futility, then something is saved. Here Nanak asks not to be in a haste. All that is meaningless will slip out of your hand one day. When you reach to the top of the hill, you will realize all that was meaningless has slipped out of your hand. Even the methods to leave the world and its affairs are meaningful. The real thing is in the hands. There is nothing worth holding in this world and there is nothing worth leaving. When you reach the destination, you will find all that was useless has slipped out of your hand. You are walking with your scripture in your hand. You can watch the people going Sunday morning to their churches with their scriptures in their hands. You reach to the destination in your different kinds of cars. When you reach the destination, you will find all that was useless has slipped out of your hand. Now only the useful has remained in your hand. Let this be the awareness that nothing can happen through your effort. That is the very moment you attain. I have heard there was a Christian saint called Saint Teresa. She was a woman of substance. One day she declared that she wants to build a huge church of God in the village. The village was small and the existing church was too small. The followers thought where to get the donations from and who will give so much money for the church. Someone asked Teresa, "It is indeed good that you want to build a huge church, but where the funds will come from?" She took out 2 pennies from her bag and said, "The work can begin with this money." The man started laughing and said, "We always found you to be crazy. You are planning to build a huge church with two pennies? Sir Teresa said, you only see two pennies. Indeed, I have two pennies and he has everything. And the most important thing is that he is with me. Can you guess how much is two pennies plus God? Teresa said she will only begin. Finally, he has to complete. Our strength is only worth two pennies. We can go only that far. The rest is his will. Your effort, sincere efforts, utmost efforts, or whatever adjective you can use for your efforts, is not worth more than two pennies. And the church was completed. That still stands as a symbol of trust. With your resources, you can only take the first step. If your first step and his indomitable energy are there, then there can be no problem. You keep your efforts only worthy of two pennies. Nanak goes on repeating, neither this nor that is meaningful. Is taking away everything from you. This is why I say, a master does not give you anything. Instead, he takes away all props from you, and thus he makes you utterly helpless. You are thirsty and in the desert where there is no source of water. There alone you will resurrect. Only then you will get the ultimate support. And remember, no one is high or low, all are equal. Never think that wise or the meditative will reach. If there is anything like this, it is because of you. Jesus says, one who loses himself will certainly attain, and one who tries to save himself will lose forever. To save yourself is the greatest mistake. The moment you realize the futility of your penniless efforts, you attain. That very moment, you can be emperor by His grace alone. You can be emperor by His grace alone. Nanak continues, and the sutras that come afterwards, some of them are very important. We are entering into last set of five or six sutras. And in one of the sutras he says that the formless dwells in the realm of truth. He gives an analogy. The mother that we consider in the world that mother is most important. Nanak says mother is like the earth. It has the capacity to grow. Everyone knows the earth because you are connected to her instinctively. All animals, they recognize their mother. The father is like consciousness that continues to flow. The word that he uses, Pavan Guru, Pani Pita Mata Dharatma. So top he puts, the master is like a breeze. You can feel its presence, but you cannot hold on. If you try to make your fist and capture a breeze, you cannot do that. Breeze touches your palm the moment it is open. The moment you try to close it, the breeze is no more. Master is like the breeze. Pani Pita, the father is like water that moves from higher altitude to the lower. This is the nature of the consciousness, descended. And the mother is like earth. And he goes on giving so many examples to explain.